and healings of all kinds right now. At the count of seven, do what you couldn't do before.
In the name of Jesus, I reverse the power working against you. Jesus mighty name. You notice that a part
listen, what you call impossibility is impossibility before the God you serve. That thing that the world has used to laugh at you, it will become a testimony. It is your faith that will see you through your wilderness.
I release a miracle of your need into your hands this morning.
Somebody shout, it is mine.
Very warm welcome to you to this special segment, Moment of Recovery. My name is Pastor Tony Okoh, like you know, and I'm going to be using this time out to encourage, strengthen people, and to bless the people who take time to watch this broadcast. I appreciate you for tuning in this time at this point to listen to me. I want to share with you the special word that God has given to me for this Ember month. And I want to pray also at the end of this broadcast, believing that your life will never be the same. I'll be looking at what I call when God chooses to remember a man. This Ember month, a lot of fears are in the air. People say Ember months have evil, destruction. But I want you to know that we can look at it from another perspective. It's a month of remembrance. This is the season where people will begin to remember you for good in the name of Jesus. In the book of Genesis chapter 8, the Bible says, and God remembered Noah and every living thing and all the cattle that was with him in the ark, and God made a wind to pass over the earth and the waters assuaged. In other words, the Bible says he was remembered by God. When God remembers a man, the Bible says from the context I'm going to show you that some things will go in favor of that man, and we're going to look at that in this broadcast. God remembered Noah, and look at what happened. He sent a wind, because at that time the whole world was being destroyed. God has sent wind to preserve him, not just him and every living thing around him. See, the kindness of God manifests every time God thinks about you. When God remembers you, something good happens in your direction. At that point, Noah and his family, they needed air because the earth had been destroyed, and the storm and the water had destroyed every living creature. But God remembered Noah and everything that was in his household. And I pray for you today that everything that concerns you, you and your loved ones, will come as a remembrance before the Lord in the name of Jesus. Now take the word ember, put out. You see, it means remember. So don't say September, October, November, December as evil months, because what you call the month, that is what the month will be unto you. And I want you to see that this season, as the year begins to come to a close, that God will remember you. And God will bless you. And God will take you to the next phase of your life. And I believe that the best is yet to come. I believe your best days are still ahead of you. And I also want to encourage you to reach out to God in prayer. We are doing a 21-day prayer and fasting, October. And I want you to be part of this prayer and fasting, because we want to recall God's mind to us and bring him to remembrance. Now, they might be saying, but does God forget? But here we find verses when the Lord remembered Noah, simple as it is. So I recognize that when God begins to think about you, something good will happen to you. And I pray as we call on his name this season of our lives, that we're going to bring God's memory to bear on us and our loved ones. And that's what prayer does. Prayer brings you before the Lord. It brings you into his memory, into his remembrance. When a man disconnects from God, from praying, he finds himself completely cut out, alienated from God's mercy. And I want to challenge you this period of the Ember months. With all the bad evil going out in the society around you, it shall be far for you, from you. And all I see is God thinking about you and your family to bless you and to prosper you in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, as we look into the scriptures tonight, you find that There are certain things that occur when God remembers a man, and I'm going to break them into three parts. And the three things that I know. Number one, when God remembers a man, God is going to show him kindness. When God remembers a man, God is going to take the man to another phase of promotion. And I want to encourage you today to connect with the Spirit of God and see God take you to the next phase of your life. There's a scripture that comes to mind, and I'd like to show you that scripture in the book of Numbers chapter 10, verse 9. I want to read something here. Numbers chapter 10, verse 9. It says, if you go to war in your land against the enemy that oppresses you, then you shall blow an alarm with the trumpets, and you shall be remembered before the Lord your God, and you shall be saved from your enemies. In other words, as you go into the battles, every day is war. You wake up in the morning, you are confronted on every side. He says, as you go out into the battles of daily living, into the battles of trying to survive, meeting up with your needs and all, this is war. He says, you must do something. He says, you shall blow an alarm with a trumpet. It's more like praying. He says, make some noise, get God's attention. And he says, you will be remembered by God. Amen. You see, these seasons of our lives, we need to begin to recognize that until we call his attention, he will not remember us. That is not to say that God forgets us. There are millions of people. It says, call upon me and I will answer you. So in other words, when you call on God, you cause him to remember you.
The shepherd to the sheep, Jehovah hears when we cry. Hoshama.
As we step into the month of September, God has asked me to call for a 21-day prayer and fasting. It's called Hoshama. That's what the program is tagged. What's the meaning of Hoshama? Hoshama means Jehovah hears.
Hoshama, the 21-day fasting and prayer meeting, holds daily at the Sovereign Word Church. Theme, God has taken away my reproach. Date, September 14th to October 14th. 5:30 p.m. daily and 7:30 a.m. on Sundays at Sovereign Word Church, 11 Awori Street, Ilebolaji, First of Ibadan, Lagos.
Don't continue the Ember months without making a contact with heaven. As we lift up our voice, we serve a God who hears when we cry.
Hoshama, Jehovah hears. He will hear you.
Blind Bartimaeus was blind and Jesus passed by. Are we saying that Jesus never recognized that there was a man that was blind? He knew. But Blind Bartimaeus had to reach out to the Lord and called on the Lord. And the Lord answered Blind Bartimaeus. Here we find in Numbers chapter 10 verse 9, he says, as you go to war in your land against your enemies that oppress you, you shall blow an alarm. This season we want to blow an alarm in our prayers as we go into a program tagged Hoshama. For 21 days, you can join us wherever you are. Be part of it if you can come to our church, worship with us, and take this period of time to pray. He said, sound an alarm, and God will remember you, and he will deliver you from your enemies. And I pray that this season will begin to provoke God's remembrance, because we need the remembrance of God to be able to survive. The moment God remembered Noah, the Bible says, it caused a wind. God allowed the things that will make for his survivor to come into his line towards him. God at this point recognized that there are basic things you need for survival. Just like he gave wind, blue wind in the direction of Noah, because that was their immediate need. They needed fresh air. God's going to release finances this Ember month. September is a season for school fees and name it. And I recognize that as you do so, that the Spirit of God is going to bless you mightily take you to another phase of your life. He says, when you go to war against the enemy that oppressed you, you shall blow an alarm with the trumpet, and you shall be remembered before the Lord your God, and you shall be saved from your enemies. Hallelujah. I want to encourage you this period that we are praying or fasting, that it's just for one reason, for God to look down on us and show us his mercy. Because the things that happen when God favors a man, they are so awesome, so wonderful. And I believe that all we need to do at this period is to provoke his attention, to get his attention, for us to be remembered. There are lots of pressing needs in our lives that are suffocating us, choking us on every side. Many of you right now watching this broadcast, you are the verge of being swallowed up. But listen to me, God will not allow the flood of death, the flood of sickness, and the flood of all kinds of satanic avarice that is ravaging you to swallow you up. Or rather, as we will lift up our hands and we cry. The Bible says you blow the trumpets of prayer, call on him at this season. And it says he will hear you and he will deliver you from your enemies. So that's a good and encouraging word for this season. Remember, most for me, and I want to believe for you, it's not a period of death or destruction or setback. It's the season where God begins to provoke all kinds of things in our lives. Now, I'm going to show you very briefly on what happens when God remembers a man. One of the first things I want to show you is in the book of 2 Samuel, chapter 9, when God remembers a man. Now, I want to bear in mind that when we talk about God remembering you, it also means somebody thinking about you, because every act of God is manifested or expressed through a human vessel. There's nothing God does without, when we say God remembered a man, it's actually God using a man's memory to think about you and to bless you. Now, we're going to look at 2 Samuel chapter 9 when we come back, how one morning David woke up and said, is there no man in the house of Saul that I should show kindness to? And then that was a turning point for Mephibosheth, the grandson of Saul, the son of Jonathan, that was crippled at the age of 5, left in Lodiba to die. Just like some of you watching me right now, you are in a place where you've been forgotten and everything has packed up. Nothing is working. There are people watching me right now. You've closed down your business, your shop, because you are not making profit. Rather, you are borrowing money to pay your staff. You are borrowing money to survive. God is going to remember you this season, because he will not forget his own. Now, I'll be back this time after this timeout. And then I also want you to now stay tuned. I'll be back after this timeout.
Life has battles and storms that brings about discouragement, discouraging situation. Woke up this morning and you've been very ill for a long time. Your brother came to thank me this morning. You've been very sick. You've been to several hospitals?
Yes, sir. Right now, I'm feeling very good.
You woke up very strong.
Okay, yes.
And this thing has been on for how many months?
It started in June. We stopped. Then I came up about 6 days ago. I was taken to about 2 hospitals. They diagnosed so many things. Until yesterday when I came to church. I didn't want to come initially.
So, January this year is the beginning of a new chapter. You need renewed strength. Somebody say renewed strength. Say louder, say renewed strength. You need something to renew fire inside of you as you look into 2014. Fire all over you. Hold her. Whoever is responsible for her torment. Yes. Why are you tormenting her? Why are you tormenting her? Fire all over you. Yes. Who are you?
I am the mother-in-law.
You are the mother-in-law. What have you done to her?
Yes, she thought she's a woman of God. She can't deliver my son. I must be with her.
She can't deliver your who?
She can't deliver my son. My son is a pastor.
Your son is a pastor?
Yes.
And you think she's a woman of God?
She says she's a woman of God. And she'll be disturbing me with prayer. I must deal with her. I must deal with her. I must deal with her.
Why do you want to deal with her?
Because she have come to deliver my son. My son, I have tied him down.
Why did you tie the son?
Yeah. It's my son now. Why should you ask me such a question?
Shut up! Why did you tie him?
I tied him down. now.
What is your gain?
I turn him down because.
Because what?
He has been doing the work of God, but he's not prospering at all. He's my son. That's why I turn him down.
So what is your gain? What is your gain? Fire all over you.
No, you can't take her from me. This woman, she thought she's a wise woman. I must deal with her. I have given her a lot of sicknesses. I must deal with her. I will not go. I will not go. I will not go. If I go, my daughter, my son will be free. My son will be free. My son will be free.
How many of them have you tied? Apart from your son, how many have you tied?
I want them 10. And I have killed all of them. Remember, only 3. And this one now, he got married, this fire. He thought that he can go. And this woman had been trying to deliver him. But no way. I must deal with her.
What have you done to this woman?
I have given her a lot of sickness.
Shut up. What have you done to this woman?
I have destroyed her work, handwork.
What
What
about her children?
No.
What about her children?
I'm not after her children. I'm after my son. My son. After my son.
What did your son do to you? And why are you killing your children? Why are you killing your children?
That is the handwork I have now.
Huh?
Since I got married. To the father of my husband. That is the work I have been doing. Killing all the children that is in the family.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. What's your name?
What are you going to do with the name now? What will you do with the name?
I release fire in your mouth. I release fire in your mouth. Fire all over you. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. What is your name?
I beg. Hey, this place is too hot.
What is your name?
Okay, I will call.
What is your name?
I'm Ankuwa.
What did you do to this woman now that you are speaking through? What did you do to her?
This woman, her future is brightening. And she said, big woman, as you see her, better have bring her down. I have bring her down for my son. My son cannot make it because if I leave this woman, my son will make it. No, I will not leave her. I have given her a lot of sickness. I must deal with her.
What kind of sickness did you give to her?
Every time she will be saying her leg is burning, her heart is burning her. I must kill her so that my son, I will be able to get her. Get my son.
Anyone tonight, hearing the sound of my voice, carrying sickness and disease, put over you by witches and wizards. I loose you by fire. I loose you by fire. I loose you by fire. Let the sickness drop out of your body. Drop out of your heart. Drop out of your chest. Drop out of your head. I command heaviness of body. Disappear by fire. Disappear by fire. Disappear by fire. Disappear by fire. Disappear. Whatever has a beginning must have an end. Now lose your son now. Lose him. Now begin to eat that death. The death you have been giving others. Swallow it. Swallow it. Swallow it. I command paralysis for your right hand. Paralysis for your left, right leg. Fire. Fire. Lose everything you have done to her. Lose her feet. Lose her heart. What's the name of your son?
James.
James.
Yes.
Release him. Release him.
Yes.
Release him.
Release him.
Release the work of his hand. Release the work of his hand. Now. Release him. From the crown of his head to the sole of his feet. Let him be delivered from your wickedness. From your grip in Jesus' name. Now wherever you buried his star. In the village. In the bushes. In the belly of the ocean. Now go there now. Spoil it. At the count of 7. Spoil it. 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. At the count of 7, Release him now, take fire. Take fire. Release him now, or take more fire. Take more fire. More fire. Fire your clothes, all of us. The mighty name of Jesus. Now lose this woman now. Lose her heart. Lose her chest. Lose her feet. In the mighty name of Jesus. Fire all over you. Go from her. In Jesus' name. Pick up. She's surprised. You're surprised? Huh? Huh?
Yes, sir.
Why are you surprised?
I was sitting there.
Huh?
I was sitting there.
So what are you doing here?
I don't know.
Huh? Can I tell you what the evil spirit said? You have just been delivered.
Yeah.
I don't know you before. Is this your first time coming?
Yes, sir.
How did you come here?
I came through sister.
Huh?
Sister Faith.
She invited you for the program.
Yes, sir.
And from the confession of the spirit that just left you now, your husband, siblings have died. There are about 10.
Yes, sir.
Your husband's siblings.
Yes, sir.
How many are they?
There are 10 in number.
So what happened to, how many are alive, how many are dead?
There are the remaining 3. 7 is dead.
7 is dead. Okay. Are you aware of the atrocities that's been going on in the family?
Anyway, I just married to the family and I heard that there are 10 and 7 have died, left with 3.
How long have you been married now?
21 years.
21 years. That's been the history. And right now, God has delivered you from a heart and leg problem.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Did you have a problem with your breathing?
Before I was having my problem, but now it's okay.
How do you feel now?
I'm okay now.
What about your feet? You feel free. What did you used to feel in your feet?
As if this side is paralyzing.
Where your heart is?
This way.
To your leg?
Yes.
You are feeling heavy.
Heaviness and as if there's no blood flowing.
And from the confession right now, it's like you're a woman of God?
Yes, sir.
What do you do?
I have widows and orphanage caring ministry.
But you're having problems struggling with the ministry?
Yes, sir.
And it's like your husband is a man of God?
Yes, sir.
What does he do?
He's a pastor.
He's a pastor?
Yes, sir.
And the ministry is not moving at all?
No.
Things are hard.
Yes, sir.
Do you know a woman they call Amiaku?
That's my mother-in-law.
That's your mother-in-law. You are surprised what we are telling you? Huh?
Sir?
You are surprised we are calling this information to you?
Yes, sir.
They came out of your spirit. We summoned the spirit behind your problem. And the spirit now appear. We now ask, who is this spirit? He said, it's the spirit of your mother-in-law. And that's exactly, it's your mother-in-law that has been responsible. Now, you are not going to fight her.
No.
The Bible said, we wrestle not against flesh and blood. Now, this is an information. Now, you have just been delivered.
Amen.
Now, you and your husband will do a 21 days prayer and fasting. Are you hearing me? You will contend that everything that woman has done be destroyed. And neutralized. I'd like to see your husband and you tomorrow.
Oh, he's in Ghana.
He's in Ghana?
Yes, sir.
His church is in Ghana?
Yes, sir.
And what the Spirit of God is telling me is that he did ministry here before. He closed down.
Yes, sir.
And then he now moved to Ghana.
Yes, sir.
And as I talk to you right now, the work in Ghana too is dying.
Yes, sir.
He's even contemplating moving again.
Anywhere we open church, before you know, the landlord or landlady will stop it.
It's your mother-in-law. And because you've been praying, your prayers have been disturbing her. And she hates you for that, that you have come to deliver her son from her hand. That's why she attacked you and spoiled everything in your hand. You have been delivered.
Amen.
Walk in the light of your deliverance from today. In Jesus' name. You're going to see great testimony. You'll hear from your husband. Give the Lord a big hand.
Like the shepherd to the sheep, Jehovah hears when we cry. Hoshama.
As we step into the month of September, God has asked me to call for a 21-day prayer and fasting. It's called Hoshama. That's what the program is titled. What's the meaning of Hoshama? Hoshama means Jehovah hears.
Hoshama, the 21-day fasting and prayer meeting, holds daily at the Sovereign Word Church. Theme, God has taken away my reproach. Date, September 14th to October 14th. 5:30 p.m. daily and 7:30 a.m. on Sundays at Sovereign Word Church, 11 Awori Street, Ilebolaji, Pastor, Ibadan, Lagos.
Don't continue the Ember months without making a contact with heaven. As we lift up our voice, we serve a God who hears when we cry.
Hoshama, Jehovah hears. He will hear you.
Now, welcome back. I'm so glad you stay tuned. Thank you for staying tuned and listening to me this evening. Now, look at Genesis chapter 41. I read from verse 9. Then spoke the chief butler unto Pharaoh, saying, I do remember my faults this day. Pharaoh was wroth with his servant and put me in ward in the captain of the guard's house, both me and the chief butler. Then Pharaoh sent and called Joseph, and they brought him hastily out of the dungeon. And he shaved himself, changed his raiment, came in unto Pharaoh. Amen. Now, what I want you to see here, a man by the name Joseph, you all know the story. That's if you are familiar with Bible scriptures. Joseph was gifted with the ability to interpret dreams, and interpreted two dreams for two different people. One was negative, one was positive. The negative one that his dream was interpreted was hanged. But the second one that had a positive interpretation, he was promoted. Restored back to the office of a butler in the house of Pharaoh. Now, this same man got into that place and forgot about Joseph. Now, while he left, Joseph said, please, when you get to the palace, don't forget me. Let Pharaoh know about me. But he was forgotten. Years after, the Pharaoh himself had a dream he could not interpret. And to God be the glory, that same butler remembered Joseph years after. When God remembers a man, He will promote him from prison to palace. Lift your hand and say, God of heaven, remember me. That's why I challenge every one of you, according to the book of Numbers I just read to you, Numbers chapter 10, verse 9. He said, when you go to battle, blow the trumpet. In other words, get the attention of God. And he said, he will remember you. We need to pray. We need to really pray. This Ember month, and talk to God. God of heaven, remember me this season. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that somebody watching this broadcast will lift up his voice right now and say, oh God of heaven, remember me. If you can pray that prayer and cry out to God today, you will be remembered by God. God is taking you to the next level of your life. God is taking you to a new season of your life. I see that there's going to be a supernatural turnaround, breakthrough on every side. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You are going through a season of despair. The year has come to an end. You are wondering, God, what's happening to me? This is September. And you're saying, God, is this how the year is going to end? But God is saying, no, my thoughts was your thought of peace to give you a future and a hope. And I prophesy in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth that there will be a major breakthrough for you. A major breakthrough. Because when you get into God's remembrance, you are set for promotion. And I believe today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, that you are moving somewhere, you are going somewhere in Jesus' name.